When coronavirus-19 hit our radar, it was a pivotal time for a lot of scientists. For the first time in a global event, the data is freely available for scientists all over the world to participate. And that's adding an enormous amount of collective energy towards finding a solution for this virus. I've never been one to sit on the sidelines and just watch something unfold. So I've looked hard for ways that I can make a contribution. We have, in my lab, always been focused on tracking where virus diversity occurs in nature and analyzing how it jumps out of natural systems and into human populations. The California Department of Health is working with a group of us experts to interpret the genetic changes that are occurring in this virus and potentially even changing its ability to transmit or even cause disease in humans. Being able to help add my expertise to understanding which genetic mutations might be the most important for finding a solution has been really rewarding.
I started to really think about what ways I might be able to contribute, what aspects of my research could help. The approaches that we take to understanding the relationship with humans and natural world and so on have a really important role to play. Basically, we have a failing economy right now. Everybody depends on everybody else, and everybody affects everybody else. And so thinking about it in that way, it's like you have a very tightly integrated ecosystem. What we did here was to propose using some of the methods that we've developed to examine how ecosystems have responded to stresses in the past, and to propose tackling the problems of socioeconomic systems under extreme stress such as they are now. Do we issue an order for all businesses and all sectors at the same time, or do we stagger it? Are there more informed ways to do it that would ease some of the fears that this shutdown is not going away anytime soon?
My job is to collect data that's going to go into a model. It's a lot of employment statistics, but also hospitalization and mortality data from COVID-19. I think it would be nice to leave some new insight into how to mitigate and navigate a pandemic or epidemic.
We're at a pivotal point now where we can take our vast understanding of how nature thrives to actually draw a connection to how natural diversity and humans can thrive together. That really is the only way forward.